holla, whatever, because he's in another one of the movies. Ain't that what Green Book is about?
Green Book is about
Green Book.
Green Book. Well, what the Green Book is a book that black travelers used as they were traveling through the South. That kind of third eye shit.
Yo, I'm woke. I'm woke. Yo,
it's for black businesses. You know, black people can always eat.
I seen the Killer Mike special.
Okay.
Yeah. So like, you know, that's where I got my enlightenment about the Green Book. He spoke about it a lot. You know what I mean?
He did.
Okay. Keep your third eye open. You feel me? You know what? The moon is in Scorpio. So the endoplasmic reticulum can't even overcome the ribosome. You feel me?
Hey, man.
Who shall I buy? You know what I'm saying? I'm out here. You know what I'm saying?
What's your number, bro?
Yo, your number, yo. You know what I'm saying?
469.
469. You know what I'm saying? 214-318. Y'all can holler at me 757. I be out there all day. Anyway, the Green Book. Talk to me, bro. I'm listening.
Nah, man. You know what it's about.
You know, I always keep the third eye open, bro. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I'm a woke ass nigga, bro.
You gotta stay on.
You feel me? Like, you know what I'm saying? I told Clayton that birds were drones. He didn't believe me. He called me a crazy nigga. Then, you know, I'm like,
birds
hey, Clayton,
are drones.
Birds are not real.
I'm going to say that again for the people. Birds are drones is what he told me to grow with. Josh, are you rolling with that?
On my conspiracy nigga shit.
Nigga, like imagine a big.
I think it might come out.
Imagine a big eagle taking a drone away, right?
It might be out. Like, but look, like all of these birds I seen, nigga, ain't drones.
But check it out. Okay, so eagles, you know how eagles just.
If
you know
really
eagles
wanted
can
to
just,
keep an eye on something.
But no, check it out. You know how eagles just fly up and just get the fish out the water? Don't you think that an eagle just fly up and get a drone? Like, I'm snatching this bitch and just take your iPhone?
I mean, but at this point,
stay
even
woke,
if
nigga. They're
birds,
all working.
Well, this
whole
is
all
a touch screen,
together
nigga,
together
and
drones,
they ain't got
nigga.
The pass. They ain't got the password.
But at this point,
say what
even
now?
If they weren't drones, you can put cameras on them and they can be drones.
Boom.
Mike Tyson was training the pigeons.
Yeah, like in chip them. Yeah.
Mike Tyson was really training the pigeons up there on that roof.
I know. Like, that's the rat of all birds.
Hey, I'm trying to tell you.
Stay woke.
That's the rat.
Y'all niggas sleep.
Alaykum salam.
Assalamu alaikum, my brother.
Yes.
Ah, brother Hunter. Wolfman.
Right
yeah,
now.
That's me. Nah, shout out to my nigga, bro. I'm just playing. Did I say the moon was in Scorpio? Did I say that just now?
You said Mercury retrograde.
You got into that bag.
You
said
Mercury
retrograde. You know why I said that, right?
That bag, bro. I didn't catch all of it.
You know
bro,
why I said that, right?
I know exactly
you on your Scorpio
why you said
shit.
It, bro.
Why I say it then?
Yeah, your Drake shit. Your Scorpio.
Nah, you know why I said that shit.
Now he fucking with his suns and his moons, and he see.
Yeah,
that.
I'm saying
some,
I'm keeping my
got,
third eye
new
all the way open.
Out talking about suns and moons.
I'm about to call this nigga. Hold on.
That shit up.
I'm about to call this nigga Matchbox Tony right now. Hold on. Where
he
is? Here he is. I'm about to call his ass right now. Hold on.
No Momo.
Yeah, I'm about to call his ass right now. Let's see if he answer.
Yo.
Assalamu alaikum, my brother. What's good?
What's good, Jay?
Where you at?
I'm on my way to the hodo. What's the word?
Nah, nigga. I thought you was going to pull up me and do the podcast thing. I'm live right now. What you on here? I seen you podcasting without me, yo. You got niggas feeling sad.
I do the podcast on Saturdays at 2:30 to 4:30.
How come you ain't call a young nigga, bro? You say, hey, look, the moon is in Scorpio, bro. I'm a Scorpio. You feel me?
Bro, why you?
You gave me a shout out, my G.
Bro, why you play so much?
What you mean? I'm not playing.
I'm just saying, bro. Why you so funny, bro?
Come on, yo. I want you to pull up on us and fuck with us. You know
you
we
at?
Love you. Hey, yo, what happened to Sore Losers? Y'all need to connect.
Fuck Sore Losers. Where you
No, nigga. We were rooting for y'all, bro. Like, y'all was like taking out the ghetto.
Hey, that's the reason why I fucked that. And fuck whoever was rooting for us but can't root for me, nigga.
Hey.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, Matchbox, guess what? Matchbox, guess what? When you had your show at Trees, guess who was the first nigga there?
Who?
Your boy. I was there, nigga. You gave me a hug. You was like, you had a live band in that hoe, nigga. I was in that bitch. I'm always supporting anything black in Dallas.
Hey.
You know that.
What's up? Where you at?
I'm at the crib right now. I'm being dead ass. Like, seriously. When the niggas, well, the reason me and my niggas like always been doing this for the past 10 years, like we trying to put y'all niggas on. We trying to like build a marketing scheme like QC out in a fucking Atlanta out here and get everybody on. We going to sell out to them other niggas. That's our goal.
Right. I mean, like, I'm cool with that. Like, bro, Do you not understand, my nigga, every move I've ever made that y'all have seen documented has been open source because of me?
Oh, I know. I'm
like,
your son.
Look at the track record. Bro,
I'm the
even
kid
when
thirsty.
I was, even before I was in the band, I never rapped on no other producers, nothing, because I wanted everybody to do it together, bro. Like niggas don't really understand numbers, bro. I've been getting to the bag, my nigga, since y'all heard my name.
I already know,
I just want a shirt.
Say, man, all I know is, like, we've been supporting you, bro. We don't really, I'm gonna speak for myself. I don't really fuck with that weirdo rap shit. I've been fucking with you, though. You was the one that leveled out y'all's group in Sore Losers, in my opinion. You feel me?
Exactly. Real talk.
And that's why, that's why I feel like, losers, you know what I'm saying? Like, certain things are kind of, like, stagnant. And I hate to see groups like y'all's, and I hate to see, like, Paris and Slim. Like, that shit was good what they had going on, too. I seen that nigga Paris drop a stupid-ass freestyle on fucking Twitter or some shit. And I'm like, yo, why is this nigga not rapping no more?
Yeah, that was fire. Well, bro, like, niggas keep talking to me about rapping, bro. Like, seriously, drop me a, where you at right now?
I'm at, here, hold on. Y'all niggas talking amongst y'all, so hold on, we gonna stop.
I mean, it's just, but it's so dope. So dope.
Posted on the black top, took me hit the jackpot, 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 end up with your back broke, matchbox, hot box, choking on some weed smoke, dope it in the kilo, low key in the stash spot, ask my partner Kilo, he know that we cash out, cry later.
Like that's what's going on right now, nigga. Niggas is dropping whole tapes with niggas.
Yo, that
none of that shit was going on in Dallas at all, and y'all niggas were that.
That niggas is killing, bro.
I hope that nigga
pull up on this, yo.
Freddie Gibbs, Mad Lib, like it's like Kenny Beats, Key, nigga, like fucking.
Man, that shit. Like I said, nigga,
nigga. You got Metro Boomin in your hood, nigga. He make beats for you. Like in all honesty.
Yeah, yeah.
You got Metro Boomin in your hood. He make beats for you. Just you.
I just want niggas to know, like, I'm always showing love. Like, it ain't about, honestly, I missed that short. That was the feel. Maybe I'm stuck from 10 years ago. Maybe I'm stuck in
a beef with Brown right now. He just pussy.
How you putting that nigga shit out there, bro? That nigga won't pull up on us. That's what it is?
Listen to me. Why aren't they working together? Did you listen to Brown on conversation?
He about to be here. He's about to pull up. If not, he going to pull up on the next podcast that drops. He's sounding like he's pulling up on us.
Did you hear him say fuck so losers?
Say, man, I heard that. He going to explain it. I don't know, bro. He gonna explain himself. That man gonna be here anyway. Let's talk about the Grammys. Look. Look. So, anyways, yo, shout out to everybody. Yo, shout out to
Duke
Fresh
on
FFC.
TV. If I get Fresh, quiet, ladies and gentlemen, Duke is on TV.
Shout out to Mahershala Ali. He won the Grammy. He had a beanie on.
Again,
that was some true.
Again on
your ass.
No, don't sleep on the nigga again. He's won another.
That wasn't a beanie, bro.
The Oscar. He won the Oscar.
Still calling it a beanie,
he had the beanie. What do you call it? The sweater cap, nigga?
Bro. That was a koofy.
That wasn't a koofy?
Yeah, it was a koofy.
A koofy is like when you got dreads, bro.
Bro,
that was definitely a koofy. A stocking cap, like from the beauty house.
He's Muslim. Like, a koofy can come in different styles. Yo, you got your formal koofy.
That shit,
you know what I'm saying? You got your, like, snapback koofy. You
got
all your
koofies.
That
shit can come in a different style. It can be different colors.
Trust.
At the beauty supply house. Nigga, trust me on that one.
Anyways, shout out to him, yo. Like I said, he was doing some weird nigga shit on Moonlight.
Nah, he a true cat, though. Like, he used to play basketball.
He like
it
beat me up, bro.
Hey, tell me the name of it one more time for me.
Koofy.
That's
a koofy. Oh, that's a good old Carhartt.
What's the name of this? This is the hat.
That's a Carhartt beanie.
That's a beanie. That's exactly what I'm saying.
That's a Carhartt beanie.
Okay, we just want to clear that up for the people. If you're trying to figure out, you was wondering what the fuck
nigga,
was Joe talking about.
Nigga, that's Photoshop. Let me see
that
again.
We're
going
to fact check on this podcast so y'all won't think we too crazy. It's Sunday if you're listening.
No, let me see that again.
That's People on Game podcast.
That's really a Carhartt beanie?
Bro, they sell them at the beauty supply, bro, on facts.
Wow, yeah. Yeah, that's definitely a beanie. Yeah, no.
But he was fresh.
I thought my G had a koofy on.
If you seen him winning his second Oscar, nigga, he was fresh.
Yeah, he was fresh.
And I do fuck with the hat when it's cold in the winter because I want my head warm. Fuck y'all. Like, why can't I wear what I want to wear on around my head to keep my head warm?
Back when I had to wear a suit to work every day, like, I leave the house with a do-rag on. You know what I'm saying?
Boom.
You know what I'm saying?
I never leave the house with the hoe.
With my suit on.
Never do nothing for me
with
on
my
the
suit
outside.
On, nigga. Everything with my suit on. You feel me?
I already know.
Durag.
I done for sure seen you in the hoe.
Fucking sweatband with my durag, or my suit on, all that what shit. Give a fuck.
Headband and durag together.
Anything with my suit on, bro. I was out there. Y'all niggas, bro.
Nah, I definitely want to, probably want to wear suits, bro, if I can make the mugs feel like,
I hate wearing suits in Dallas, yo, especially if, like, for work. That's ass.
Nah, if I can get it to feel like sweats.
I'm good, fam.
Man, I wish I could wear a suit.
Nigga, I was a Jehovah's Witness. Like, that was my first sales job. So, like, I was wearing a suit, like, knocking at your door at 9 o'clock
like
in the morning.
Joint, bro.
Like,
not the motherfucker that.
They real conservative. Like, Jehovah's Witness is real conservative. So, you couldn't have, like,
the right
fresh
material.
Linen suit.
It's
like,
a suit, but just the material of the suit be like.
The hell just all cotton. Like, you know what I'm saying? Oh, there's some breathable fit, fabric
or
whatever.
I think I can wool it out and it will work out.
I'm good, fam. Any more takes from the Oscars? Oscar.
Spike Lee was kind of hating on Green Book winning the Oscar for
Best.
How
you
say that? Why you say that?
More than Spike Lee's film?
You said what?
Did you enjoy Green Book more than Spike Lee's film?
You know what? I actually like both of the films, to be honest with
you. So I never seen Green Book.
You didn't have a
favorite. I tried to get into Black Klansman.
Because I did think they were both pretty good movies. Although I kind of canceled out a Green Book at one point.
Why is that?
Was it a little bit slower than Black Panther?
I didn't really care if I cared about the story. Like two guys kind of kicking it together. Like, I mean, just off top. When I could be watching so many other things, like developing some knowledge or something, I didn't think that this story was
your third
a
eye
story
open,
that
you know
I cared
saying?
About. This black dude and white dude, but it ended up being a really good movie, and I hate that I did sleep on it. But like just concept wise, I kind of just don't want to be sitting watching
two niggas just kicking
bond
in.
And shit.
Yeah,
that's facts.
But like y'all related or what's going on here?
And I had just seen this nigga in Moonlight, so just like, what's your bag, bro?
Yeah,
it was just rough.
He was doing the bonding thing and that shit too, bro.
And it was like, kind of the reverse Driving Miss Daisy.
Oh
yeah, it is.
What, Green Book?
Yeah,
I never. I got
so the black man riding in the back seat of the car.
I'm gonna give y'all my say.
Oscar winner now. It was best film.
You know what I'm saying, but I never peeped it. I mean, sure, what the
but
fuck?
But no, I'm just saying, like, now that's gonna be
a
dope watch.
I'll give y'all my take on that shit next
movie,
week. And that's what Spike was mentioning when he got on stage. He had a rant and he was saying that.
I know he had a long list. He had a big. He had that yellow notebook paper from the tab you tear away. I was like. I think he had that for 50, like, what, nominations? He's been holding that hole in his pocket forever, Josh.
He said the first time he lost Best Picture was to Driving Miss Daisy. Mm. He's like, they got him again.
So why do you think he was salty, though?
He basically got up there and had a rant about being salty that he didn't win, you know what I'm saying, the award.
What, years ago?
That award.
Oh,
he thought he should have won for Black KK.
Got you. So what did he win for? I thought he won for Black KK.
He won an award, but he didn't win Best Film.
So what award did he win?
So the biggest award is
what
the
award
best
did he
film,
win, though?
Huh?
What award did he win? I just know he won one. I was watching it, bro, but I was like watching it kind of passive. Like, yeah,
same.
You don't even know.
Nah, I don't. But
I don't even feel like Googling
it.
I don't give a fuck.
Best screenplay.
Yeah,
boom.
Yeah, that's what it was.
That's one in the same, I guess.
He was a nominee for Best Picture.
But Best
Picture
is like
he was also
like,
nominee.
Like, that's what Spike's saying. If I got the best screenplay, you
what
trying to
mean?
Say they shot their shit better than mine? And it was.
He was nominated for Best Director.
The way he
also.
Shot his shit was really good. So it's like, damn, nigga, if I had the best screenplay.
Well, you always pay attention to details, in my opinion. Like all his movies, like Crooklyn, even the old joints, he always pays attention to detail.
They don't ever show love, but he finally got one.
They don't probably don't tap into it, like you know, a lot of movies you're naming. Like, yo, I didn't really tap into it.
I guess they kind of tap it in now by him even winning screenplay. But it's like
I think black culture is the culture. I've said that before a million times. Like we are the culture. We are the hot sauce. You feel me? Like I think like black people are the hot sauce to American culture. You know what I'm saying?
Of course.
Yes, I'm saying. So
we are the
like they have to pay attention. To his film or whatever, and they might not like you know you just can't fill up on hot sauce though. You feel me?
Yeah. I already know, but like that's why he didn't win Best Picture, and it spoke more to why I didn't really want to watch that mug.
Got you.
Is because of the dichotomy of what they were trying to sell.
Right, we saying the same thing then.
Right, but you could appreciate the storyline definitely. So that
and what
the,
Black Klansman.
Yeah. So the
I couldn't delve too deep.
So the award he actually won was the one he should have won. You know what I'm saying? The screenplay was dope.
Yeah,
you know
absolutely.
What I'm saying? For sure.
Fucking like I
the
said,
story.
like I said earlier off mic, your girl Lady Gaga was looking like a fucking cutie. And I'm not talking about a cutie, I'm talking about them oranges. The oranges called the cuties. You know what I'm saying? She looked like she's looking mad orange, yeah. And she was looking like she was trying to kiss my boy Bradley Cooper, like on the lips. But I think that nigga married or got like a whole like girlfriend or fiance. But like they was looking real like you know what I'm saying? Like my wife would have pulled me off that stage if I was up there all cozy on Lady Gaga. Irina, she would have really fucked me up.
Hey, Irina not really tripping. You talking about young Bradley Cooper?
Yeah.
Hey, Irina, you know Irina?
No, that's his girl?
Yeah.
Nah, I don't know
her. She not really tripping, bro.
I don't know that bitch.
Oh, yeah.
Nah, I don't know
her. Bradley went and scooped her because of who she was. Yeah. I mean, he do his own thing, but, like, he was like, oh, yeah, that's
the only open
model,
relationship.
That's the model
shit.
Joint.
They're in the open relationship.
That's the model. Now nah, he went and got him a little, like, a model, bro. Like, a legit, like.
I'm a little one of them things, huh?
Yeah, for, I mean. Yeah. On some Bradley Cooper shit, he did like a Bradley Cooper move, so like he wasn't really tripping on the guy. This is another day he got to act live in front
of
everybody.
Yeah, you know, so we just acting. You know, I might kiss her tonight. You know what I'm saying? Something light, not too serious.
I could be.
Yo, could you imagine living that lifestyle? Like, yo, you know what I'm saying? We might go up there and sing a little ditty, or whatever, and I might have to kiss her
tripping,
on the mouth.
Bro.
You know,
hold on.
But like, you know, I'm an actor. You know what I'm saying? So like, it's not real. How does that work? How does that work?
He literally does that in movies. So like what he did on like Oscar night, that was nothing.
Yeah, I feel you though, but I don't know.
He be going there. He got a lot of movies, bro. He been acting for.
Yeah,
a long time.
I seen him in a lot of shit. He ain't one of my favorites, but I'm like, I've seen him out there.
But I mean, fucking Hangover is kind of classic.
I'm just acting.
He gonna
me
win
and Lady
with that
Gaga,
one. If nothing else, he gonna be able to make it with that one.
You know what I'm saying? If I just tongue her down, like, it's nothing. we just playing, you know? Like, we just trying to,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Get them numbers up. You know I'm going to give it back to you, baby, when I get this money. You know what I'm saying? Get the fuck out of here. Fuck him, bro. Like, fuck out of here. He a creeper, bro. I'm watching this nigga, man. Like,
you got your eye on him?
Yeah, bro. He the next R. Kelly type nigga, bro. I got my eye on him. I was like, yeah, this nigga being creepy, yo. Like, son.
I think nobody
knew he could sing. We didn't find that out until like last week too. You know what I'm saying? Yo, turn your volume down. This shit buzzing on the phone and shit. Put your phone on vibrate, nigga.
I think R. Kelly has successfully made it to every
episode.
It's
like clicking, like yeah.
What do you think?
Good look.
I don't know,
bro. What happened now?
You think?
But he know.
You think R. Kelly made it successfully to each episode? Now
to what?
To each putting people on game podcast episode.
What you mean? Made
seven.
It to
like a mention.
Oh, yeah. No doubt. Yeah.
He gets a mention every time.
Like, I was talking about him before. I knew.
So
he
we
was
haven't
rapist.
Muted R. Kelly at all. And this nigga
R. Kelly.
Out.
We knew
he was out. We ain't heard nothing from him. He out and ain't nobody tripping.
R. Kelly's out.
I heard Oprah,
he out, bro.
Oprah fucking with Michael Jackson.
And fucking with him like he might be a pedophile?
She's interviewing the Michael Jackson victim from years ago.
Man, fuck and, Oprah.
And this motherfucker
bitch.
Still dresses. He dresses
fuck,
like Michael
man,
Jackson.
Are you serious? Oprah's anti-MJ? Are y'all team MJ or
well,
Oprah?
I mean,
wait, no, fuck this.
I think that was something
no,
that wasn't
this.
Talked
now,
about while he
right
was
now,
alive, bro, but now he dead.
Are you team
just,
MJ or you
she
team
She gets to
Oprah.
Eat off of that nigga and not even be
like,
cool
leave
with that
dead
nigga.
Leave a dead man alone, bro.
But, like, that's some Oprah shit. Like, she can definitely eat
yeah,
off
I know
of
he
Michael.
Wasn't
one
shit.
More,
he can't
even
defend himself.
That's fuck you, Michael. That's like
I
a fuck you,
Michael. I think she interviewed him as a kid, too, didn't she?
Who gives a fuck, man? Like, you can't fuck with...
I feel like they had some type of, like, relationship at one point, but it's like, I think it ended up bad. And like it never got good, and he died. And this just was like her.
That's some hoe shit,
Michael. Exactly.
That's some hoe shit. Fuck that shit, man. Like I love Oprah, but fuck you, Oprah. Like,
so she supporting
you. You gonna forever be my girl, but
she
fuck you. That's stupid.
Performed at the Super Bowl.
Said what now?
She performed at the Super Bowl, basically, she, nigga. Doing the MJ story shit. Is like that. That's the equivalent that she gonna have on OWN TV.
Look at me. I don't think the OWN's doing that good though.
The Michael Jackson shit is gonna be great. You
yeah,
think Lifetime
be
was own. Loving that R. Kelly
but
shit?
But Lifetime been popping. Oh, Lifetime.
But Lifetime was loving that R. Kelly shit though. They didn't have.
But Lifetime been popping. That's the shit they do,
to,
fam.
Huh?
That's the shit that they do on Lifetime,
but
bro.
But it's all content though, so it's like it's all about numbers. Like, how can you get niggas here on a Thursday, nigga?
I get you, but what I'm saying is like Oprah trying to dig in the Lifetime bag, like. Yo, like,
absolutely.
Like, I'm tired of doing all these
but
rerun
she was
Tyler
like,
Perry
doing
shits.
Her own Tyler
but she
Perry
was,
shit over
she
here.
Was never a Tyler Perry chick. Like, she was always, yo, in my opinion, she was kind of Uncle Tom. You know what I'm saying? In my
say
opinion,
one more time
you feel
for
me?
The people. One more time
hey,
for the
man.
People.
I ain't Black History. She's kind of an Uncle Tom, yo.
You're talking about
like Oprah's kind of an Uncle
Tom. You're talking about
C-Leaby? Oh, snap. She definitely wasn't fucking with the hip-hop, and we remember her.
That's
for
what
that.
I'm saying, yo. She the main one trying to run down
the
Snoop Dogg record.
Can we get an Oprah title
shit?
Podcast?
Back in the day.
Playlist? Oprah playlist on Tidal or something? Like, I haven't seen no
Oprah's
music.
Oprah's not, like, for the people at all. So.
I see the Obama playlist. What's the Oprah playlist?
Hey, Oprah's not for the people, bro.
Like, I need to know that. Like, if she has a lit playlist, then I might let her make it. But it's like, she has some really weak shit, then we're going to have to counsel her, bro.
I love my Black women. She's not, like, for real. But they're, like, they are the minority of the United States, right? Shit, you know what I'm saying? How was Oprah the boss bitch billionaire? Oh, shit, you know what I'm saying? She had to do something. Like, she's, like, somebody gave her, like, a whole bunch of money. Like, yo, can you throw Michael Jackson under the bus real quick for us?
Nah.
Yes, nigga, what you mean? Nah. No, I'm serious.
Gave her a whole bunch of money. No, nigga, she owned the network that they bought the shutters on, and you gon' watch it.
They're sponsors, though. They're sponsors, though, so she has to get money in
like,
turn.
Like, she can
like,
get a nigga to sponsor the hell because they gonna want in
well,
on
yeah,
that hoe the ad
nigga.
Time
yeah,
dollars
that's what I'm saying.
Owns
like,
the,
that's where the money comes from.
That's
like,
what I'm
like,
talking
oh,
about.
They bought a shit and thing. Like, somebody's like, yeah,
it's the
Oprah,
last
we about to give
Michael.
You a stupid bag. Like, I'm advertising all my shit on
but she don't have to shop that around. You know
she don't
saying?
Have
you
to shop it. Yeah, no. All she does is put the Batman network. Signal in the sky.
No,
like, yo,
I'm
going to
have it
on
own and make you niggas come get it from me. Yeah. What are you talking about? She's doing the most biggest fuck you, Michael, nigga. I've been
saying that's what I'm saying, though. But that's some Uncle Tom shit. She learned from a long time ago. Like, that's not true, yo. She's
never been
true. She's singing like Tekashi.
Oprah, you
she's
never
singing.
Seen Oprah and thought she was true. She was just getting money.
She
was
double D, double D. She's singing, nigga.
She get money, bro.
Fuck that shit.
She doing whatever she got to do to get that money.
Money
nigga.
Not everything. I mean, it's something, but like it's not
but
everything.
We always
like,
knew Oprah wasn't
money's
thrill.
Not anything to Oprah Winfrey. Thrill? Like, come on, why you got to sing
on,
like this,
man.
Bitch? Like, shut up. Even if you do know something, shut the fuck up.
Like,
shut the fuck up. If you know something, shut up, bitch.
Like, trill? Oprah was never trill.
You're not keeping it.
I used to watch Oprah, and she was never trill.
You're not keeping
on
it
no episode. Nah. So it's like, that's not going to, like, really bother me that she's being Oprah, nigga, and trying to get another last interview back. Like, she always trying to get an
Stop.
Interview back.
Stop
hey,
it.
Hey, listen to me. The Ralph Lauren interview was amazing. Please go watch that host.
Yeah, I've seen it, nigga.
But it's just like, she does dope as
she
interviews.
She had one, yeah, when she was outside, like in a TP or whatever, and it was all, like, all Ralph Lauren, all that shit, rodeo. Yeah, I've seen that shit, man.
Boom.
It was dope.
Classic, nigga.
Fucking
iconic, nigga.
Then she did the Tommy one to clear up all that racist shit. Like, you, that wasn't.
Show your kids.
That didn't happen, right? Woo, woo, woo. You know what I'm saying?
Like, here's a documentary for your ass.
Yeah, man. Fuck. Oprah, man, you tripping, man.
Hey, she was never true.
What's
bro.
Up with Stedman, yo? He need to talk some sense.
He don't be saying nothing,
what's
bro.
Where's Big
Sted,
man?
Nigga just be playing
back.
His role,
yo, inbox
bro.
Him. Call him.
My nigga
call
don't
Stedman.
Be in TMZ or nothing,
call
bro. He
Stedman,
above
DM,
all of that,
bro. You can call him on the DM. Call his ass real
this
quick.
This nigga never went live.
Get Stedman
you
online.
This nigga ain't live.
No, hello, Clayton. Stedman.
Nigga never appeared in a video, nigga.
Well, I haven't touched Oprah in about 27 years.
Like, Oprah, not
nigga,
Oprah.
That nigga,
Dyson, yeah, Oprah,
nigga Dyson Pineapples.
What you think his net worth is?
More than mine.
Josh, just go ahead and
more
put
than
it
mine.
Out there, man. I don't want to get into
it
what
doesn't matter.
I think his
more
net
than
worth
mine.
Is, nigga.
I was just curious.
Curious to put it out there, then, nigga.
Yeah,
we're all curious now that you've asked, nigga.
$125 million, I'm guessing.
I'm looking at $10
million. $10
million? 125 is going to be crazy. I was just like, where you get
know.
The 125 from?
If he's only making $10 million, he's a broke bitch. He's a janitor compared
to
her.
No, he
what's
wouldn't
Oprah's?
Be able to
be what's
quiet
Oprah's?
With 125.
Since you doing silly nigga shit, what's Oprah's right now? Yeah, what you talking about?
She build up.
No, cause I'm gonna do the comparison. Cause if his is $10 million, like I'll go commit
up.
Suicide. I'll go commit suicide if I was him.
Bro, she pretty much $2.5 billion.
$2.5 billion. Yeah,
her taxes cost more than what he made.
Every
she
year.
Can't even pay his taxes.
Every year. What two chains?
He's not worried about nothing, bro.
Yeah.
He got $10 million.
But she, her girlfriend's, whatchamacallit?
I heard you bitches like,
her girlfriend's,
whatchamacallit?
What's her name?
His little whatever life is so cool with the billionaire girlfriend.
Her girlfriend's, what's her name?
Robin.
Yeah, boom. Yeah.
I already know.
Yeah.
She's
yeah.
probably doing that, the Whitney Houston with her.
I know. They both getting it in. That boy Stemming want to get a threesome so bad, but he can't even come out the basement.
Never was too trill of me.
Like, I come up here and at least just get a threesome?
She wasn't fucking with none of the shit I fuck with. I was just fucking with the interviews.
Nah.
So it's like, I would hate to say it, but like if Narwhal had like some weird shit going on, I wouldn't be like, ah.
Narwhal who? Stemming? Yeah, but Narwhal and Stemming?
But like, no, that's like how one. The Oprah thing is like, she was never trill. So it's like, you just be watching the interviews, the content she give. But this is like. Cool.
Harpo?
I'll let it, bro. Color Purple is a classic,
fuck
bro.
Fuck with Oprah, nigga.
You don't?
No, I don't fuck with Oprah,
damn,
man.
Bro.
I'm an ignorant nigga, bro.
I didn't really like her as an actor. I don't want to gas her up. She was never a great actor.
I do not. I fuck with the opposite of Oprah, bro.
I
do fuck
with cool.
Dr. Phil is kind of funny. Yeah,
she did give us Dr.
Phil. He
kind
of funny. He gave us Dr. Phil. Yeah, shout out to you. You gave us our white Jesus.
She
gives
a lot of good interviews, though.
Yeah, she does.
I'm sure she's done a lot, bro, to help a lot of people, bro. But, like, I don't think she's trill. I think she's really cool, dope, maybe. I
Harpo?
Know. I fuck with Oprah, bro.
Oprah
I can't
is
just be like, hell no, I don't fuck with Oprah.
Black Jesus, kind
but
of.
I don't
know
how much I can fuck with
black
her.
Black people love Oprah.
She's not trill.
But she's not
I
black.
Know.
Black people don't let you jump on the couch.
I know, letting Tom
you know
Cruise get busy on there.
She not, yeah.
Yeah, you right.
Boy, what is, she just tell him.
Get your little ass off her.
Know not to do that. Don't let him be Tom Cruise
you know,
that day.
Grab him by the ankles, that nigga fall back.
But yeah, that,
you
she did always like keep that. Like, Cruise, that was what she needed to do for media, and she didn't
shit.
Really like.
He was
be
fucking
trill.
With.
If she
was,
what was
it? Katie
TV?
Holmes fucked them up.
Oh, she had been trill on TV, yeah. Man, and kept
was,
it trill.
And it was sad. Is like Jamie Foxx is fucking that bitch on the low. He don't give a fuck. He ain't jumping on nobody.
Even on the low right now.
But not.
He not fuck. He not jumping on nobody.
Wendy Williams shit. But like really, just be trill, Oprah. You got everybody came through. All you had to do just keep it trill with them.
We been fucking with you. My nigga Dave Chappelle pulled up on you. Like you. Keep it G.
Just keep it trill. But she couldn't keep it trill.
Why you gotta be out there telling?
She like it,
like if
she was
Oprah,
always around Whitey.
She salty cause she didn't get the R. Kelly story.
She's just, oh,
you think that's what it is?
Oh man,
oh.
Bro, imagine Oprah had the R. Kelly story. If she had that on her network,
she'd have ripped R. Kelly a new one. Boy,
that probably been better. That'd have been better. He
got no kids,
huh?
Stemming ain't got no kids.
Stemming,
yeah.
I don't know why you so nosy.
We talking about Stemming right now, nigga. What the fuck? So now his kids is out the question if we talk about this nigga. We just pulling his whole network up.
I don't think he have
up.
Any kids. I mean, does Oprah have any kids?
Listen to me. I don't know none of these.
Allegedly.
We know about everybody's kids, but they kids is what I'm talking about, nigga. I ain't been nosy, nigga, but like.
I don't know shit.
I know about Kanye and Jay-Z's kids, nigga.
I don't know
too much about them, but you know they have kids, nigga.
I joke around about Oprah and Stedman. I ain't even really start to. I don't know what they got.
I don't give a fuck about none of this shit,
Stedman
bro.
Stedman might come kill me, bro.
I don't know, Stedman, bro, but the 2.510 was crazy.
Say, man, he got more bread than me.
That's crazy. What I'm talking about. I said that shit earlier. He ain't tripping on having $10 million with the $2.5 million billion-dollar girlfriend.
Yeah, that boy Stedman used to hoop, though.
He can hoop?
6'7". Hooped in college. Ball State.
Do he be hooping with Obama? He look like he probably a nigga that hooped with Obama.
That nigga was probably like Obama shooting gun.
Yeah. But you see nigga throw out the glass?
Yeah.
So we're back. And I'm tired of talking about the fucking Oscars.
No?
Yeah, I'm done with it, yo. Like, okay, the last thing is, and I told you a billion times, that Pharrell's outfit was a little bit, you know what I mean? Like, I don't like that shit.
My nigga say he not fucking with the pearls.
I'm not fucking with the short suit. I'm not fucking
with
the pearls.
Oh, yeah, I fuck with the short suit.
I'm not fucking with any of that. I like the ice on the pearls. That was dope. Like, how he had the gold up or, like, the white gold, like, Pharrell joint. But, like, niggas should never wear pearls. Clayton's been debating me forever. You know what I'm saying? We didn't have a billion takes on this podcast. And
Not necessarily.
not necessarily about
I'm
pearls.
I'm fucking with you. But,
you
nah, I thought that shit was kind of hard. Not even kind of hard. Like that was probably like some of the better jewelry accessory game that I seen at the damn Oscars.
I guess it was cool, but like I just niggas should never wear pearls in my opinion.
Well, I mean, I've seen that nigga wear a lot of short suit sets.
I've seen a lot of weird shit, period. And like it's just
and then that was camo. I mean, like, why was he there though? He's the best producer at the Oscars.
Yeah, no doubt. He's the best producer, like just kind of period, bro. Like he's got a lot of cuts.
He's won an Oscar, right? Because I feel like he did the
He might have not even been nominated. He's definitely got
Me soundtrack.
Yeah, so he been eating.
He ain't no stranger to the Oscar game. You know what I'm saying?
So, I mean,
him coming in the camo joint was cool. I mean, he don't really need to be ready to go up there because he wasn't going up there. So he's just going up in there being fresh in camo, which is really dope because that's probably how he felt. Like, I'm just trying to just be a fly on the wall here and watch because I know y'all going to let me come in here.
A fly on the wall in a short suit.
Yeah. I mean, it's they in L.A., nigga.
Ant-Man.
They in L.A. I want to wear a suit. So it's like,
yeah, I don't like that shit.
I definitely would fuck with the suit joint, but not too often.
You wear a short suit?
I fuck with probably wearing suits all the time, bro, honestly. Like, if I can get that hoe with the right material, nigga.
You just wear suits all the time?
Every day, nigga. Yeah.
I probably would, bro. I just wouldn't fuck with the white socks he had on.
He had long socks on?
He had some,
I think the socks is all in with the shoes you wearing, bro.
Like, yeah, I never wear long socks ever.
Never?
Well, I guess, yeah, like, if I have a suit on, yeah.
Boom.
But not short suits. Like,
but, like, he probably had on, like, some McNairies or some, like, crazy, like, hard-bottom shoes where it's like, I know you looking at my legs, nigga, look at my socks. Like, it's just some fly shit. When you wearing shorts, definitely if you wearing shorts, nigga, you can wear the long socks. When you do the short suit, usually he wears the ankle socks.
This time, apparently, when you get older, they don't let you wear these joints.
I know, yes. Oh, that's boom. Ass, dog.
You see it?
So he usually
that nigga looks stupid. Like he with his mama right now. Like he look like his mom going to church
shoes
right now.
Hard.
That shit looks fucking suit stupid. Hard.
Usually he wear the ankle hard, socks like
oh
that.
Maybe not those
God,
socks.
God, that nigga looks stupid.
But like,
bro.
What socks you gonna wear? Oh, that's real.
That looks stupid. That's dope to you. That shit look fucking stupid. That nigga snatched up on Cedar Springs. Real quick. Hey,
you say that boy look like a Cedar Spring boy.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's about the fashion part of it.
Nigga, that ain't shit. I'm good. That ain't the fashion part I'm trying to be a part of, dog.
Nah, bro.
I don't need to see that. Nah, I'm good. Sure. Nah, I'm good.
I definitely fuck with suits, though. So I can't just stop. You don't wear no shorts? You done with you fuck with any shorts? You fuck with jean shorts?
Yeah. Jorts? Nah, only if they cut off.
So you know that's what
I'm
saying?
I retired those like
camos,
in 03.
Basketball shorts.
I'm not a big shorts nigga, man. Like,
now we getting into the real. What's really going on, nigga?
Like, nah, I mean, I have a lot of. I have shorts, but
it'd be hot as fuck in Texas, nigga. So like, if you can get off of shorts,
having girls freaking out like that. Like, look at that nigga's calves. He's a monster.
All my short shoes would be paying.
That bitch, I'm taking. All right, relax.
Hey, I ain't gonna lie, nigga. I definitely had some summers. I was on my hell. Nah, I'm only wearing jeans. But it's just like
them nuts are sweaty.
I definitely might have to fuck with some shorts.
What's smelling bad?
If I can get the shorts,
so next a nigga wildin',
yeah,
fucking lots of music drops, son.
Lots of music,
whole gang. I don't even know where do we start, yeah.
Man, I want to go straight to the baby, but like I love the Solange and the 2 Chainz is killing the streets. But it's so much.
I tell you, do me one.
It's so much.
Do me
music.
One. All right, yo. So play your best banger from everybody. We got Solange the Baby. We got Lil Skies. Hold on. What else? Who else we got?
Just for shits and
so
giggles.
Much. T-Pain dropped one. He dropped the one up on
T-Pain.
If you could play
one
banger,
on
I tell you what, play one banger from each one of them joints, son. Let one rock out. So I can just be like, nah, nigga, that ain't it. Because I know you want to play some dumb shit.
Because we got to show a little love to Summer, cause like I want to know how you felt about your boy hopping on her track and remixing it, even though we ain't heard from
Drake. Drake on the Summer
time.
Walker.
Who?
Oh man,
you got the Drake on the Summer Walker track.
Can I get
no
some volume?
Shit.
Yeah.
I was asleep. Huh?
Let me get some volume, bro.
You got audio? Go ahead.
Oh yeah, Slow Jam Clayton.
What this is?
DJ.
This what is Aubrey Graham, bro.
Oh yeah. Honestly.
Trying to McConnell her shit.
Honestly, I have heard this
on the radio.
Yeah, you have heard. That's where I probably heard it.
And this hoe's probably like dead, but no, it just came out brand new shit.
I don't think I can wait. I just need it now. Let it swing my way.
Take her back.
I just need some dick. I just need some.
Oh yeah, I have heard this.
Yes,
it's Drake.
But like Drake hopping on this mug is like, what he doing on this one? He got no business.
So wait, he's on this shit right now?
This is the remix.
I'm gonna let this hoe rock out then. Sorry, listeners. I'll leave some good show notes so you pass by this shit if you want to hear. You listen to this shit, though.
Girls can't never say they need it. Girls can't never say nah. Girls can't never say they want it. Girls can't never say how. Girls can't never say they need it. Girls can't never say nah. Oh, nah. Just throughout the week.
Album. I know we won't get there. It was kind of short too, bro. Like 39 minutes. But we'll get there. We'll get there. We'll unpack that later. Hold on. Let's let this ride out, y'all.
Niggas
sorry.
Is mad. The sorry. Albums ain't long enough. It's the most beautiful thing in music.
It wasn't even that.
We'll
talk about it.
I get it. But it was cool. Really enjoyed it. But it was like, that's it.
Damn, son, where'd you find this at?
You just need someone is calm and patient, submission, domination. Arch back, deep stroke, white wine, we smoke, that's my best combination.
Say word?
You just need some.
What happened now?
He's about to do something special for this.
Yeah.
But it's like, the chicks that was already, just need that sold out some Walker concert, late night attention, drink verse on this hoe.
Right.
They feel
a way
about
this. All right, y'all, come on, kill me on this. Kill the shit. Kill the shit. All right, yeah, it's good. Yeah, I heard this before. Yeah, they actually pushing it like in our local market on the radio. I heard it quite a bit. So, yeah, that's a good cut. What else was good? So, 2 Chainz, what's your hot take? What's your hot joint on that one?
Man,
what you got?
I like that. Mama, I hit a lick. You know what I'm saying with Kendrick.
Mama, I hit a lick. Oh, okay. So I never listen. That's your hot take, chilly, right?
Chilly, it's Kendrick. Chilly, it's Chance. Chilly. Wait, amazing.
Town chilly. Yeah. Tell my mama I hit a lick. Tell my mama I hit a lick. Mama, I hit a lick. Mama, I hit a lick. I'm coming, baby, send the address. Progress never digress. Your last man to pass the fly test. I eat rappers, no digest. Fuck a piece, I want the whole pie ground.
And listeners, these guys are just dancing around like some lucky fools right now. So, y'all got the hip-hop Holy Ghost. Y'all niggas got the hip-hop Holy Ghost right now.
Nah,
this hoe is hard. Y'all niggas got the hip-hop Holy Ghost.
That nigga's crazy. I know you been jamming it. Yeah.
If not this song, then the statutes of limitations.
All right, run that.
Because he actually dropping real shit that he did.
No,
you know
run that real quick. Run that real quick. Run that real quick for me.
Okay.
Statute of limitations. I ain't made a play since 2011. Gotta talk my shit.
Just a little change.
That nigga say the time done ran out on all of this shit, so he can talk about it now. All
right, let's get it.
Mac down your street, I had a bag full of bombs. Southside nigga, I used to serve Lil John. On Gabby Road, I shot dice with troops. Hit the D Mall and then I serve big on. Anytime 50 came to town, I serve buck. Anytime the Sixers play the Hawks, I seen Chuck. Had a half a ticket before I met with Def Jam. Asked Chris and 20 who was the X-Man. No Wolverine, hell. Collect $100 bills like a souvenir. Carbon 15 hit me, Jeezy wanna zip. And Weezy gon' buy everything except a brick. See, I can run the check up and you just run your lip. See, I can run the check up and you just run your lip. I can run the check up
okay.
And you just
okay.
Run your lip.
Okay, I see you.
I can run
all
the
right.
Check up and you just run your lip.
Alright, so what you got? Yeah, that's your favorite album that dropped
no.
This week, or what you got?
Shit,
I mean, that's obviously that's maybe one of your favorite albums. That's your favorite cut from the new 2 Chainz joint.
Nah, that wasn't.
What
bro.
You got, yo? One more because really we'll never, obviously, one, we're never gonna make it on YouTube.
I fuck with this motherfucker.
Hit me up like DM me like, why don't you make a video on YouTube? I'm like, we never can ever. Oh, this is my joint right here.
This is what I needed from 2 Chainz, Lil Wayne, and E-40.
Like
this is $2
bill.
My
right here.
Like a
like a $2 bill.
My shit, man. Yeah, I like this. This is like snap, too.
This is what I need my music to do.
Clay, how many slaps you give it? Out of five slaps, how many slaps you get? How many slaps did the album get?
Oh yeah,
what the album get? How many slaps did the album get?
Really,
how you getting five slaps? The album get five slaps?
I gotta give it 4.5 spins, bro. I don't wanna do them like that. Yeah, bro.
Okay.
It's a four slap album, but he had a lot of tracks on it.
4.5 slaps, yeah.
Four slaps at least.
One thing I know about Chain, what I heard, I was listening to the
turn down a little bit, bro. Right,
I don't know if you heard the like a Soundwave mixed by Ali. They're all on Red Bull.
Yeah.
Doing like a
little
interview.
Something
whatever,
like that.
Bro.
Yeah.
Like they're kind of just talking about how, like, when they go into the album mode, that they go into like trying to make a classic and like sequence it. And like, they got like a bunch of like hard songs that they could have put on other albums. But like, if they don't fit the sequencing, they don't even make the album.
Yeah, it makes sense.
But it's just like where a lot of niggas are just like making hot songs and they just putting them on the album. Like, I don't know how many people are trying to make like a full, like every track slap joint. No,
right.
Niggas just kind of like putting like, oh, this produced, I did this in this amount of time. And like these albums was what I was fucking with. But it's like, I don't know if I'm gonna fuck with the whole 2 Chainz album to give it 5 of them hoes, because 5 is kind of hot.
No, I'm not gonna give it 5 slaps.
I get 4.5 slaps. It ain't all the slaps,
bro. Out of all the albums, I listen to every album that drop. I think somebody snuck something in though. The baby snuck that one in.
The baby may have had all five slaps.
Yeah, he got 5 slaps.
I think before we skip, don't fail to mention LeBron James A&R, the 2 Chainz album.
Man, come on.
No. I don't really care about what LeBron.
You got to let niggas know
y'all
that shit. That's for real.
I told y'all about the KD shit. I don't care what LeBron James is doing near the music shit. Like, as long as he hooping as the best player on the court, nigga.
That's never going to influence
anything. If he don't wake up one day and do what Adrian Broner did and say, I'm about to start rapping, nigga, then I ain't worried about it, bro. And as long as y'all keep putting that nigga around the music, giving his little, he can do it too shit, cool. I know y'all just getting that little marketing bag, nigga. Like, you might give him an executive producer credit, nigga, just to use the name, nigga.
It's that rapper go to the league shit, bro.
My nigga Dame Dash did it with Kanye West, nigga.
Like, but LeBron James is, like, just as relevant as Shaq is in music to me. You know what I'm saying?
But, like, the LeBron cosign would be probably the greatest thing for 2 Chainz album, nigga, to have that affiliation. Like, have that nigga doing videos or have ESPN.
I think Titty Boy's hanging his. Well, they are one of the same. Well, they're kind of in the same market,
the
though. Like,
yeah.
You know, LeBron James, LeBron, 2 Chainz is a ball player. Like, they're kind of in the same market. Like, that nigga just, basically, like, 2 Chainz
like,
be at ESPN.
On it is more of like
2
Chainz
be at ESPN
about.
All the time, too, hanging out. Yeah. I see that nigga all the time on ESPN with his little hot takes and shit. So, you know, they kind of one the same. So I can see how their relationship would work well. But other people, it's like, yo. Shut up, LeBron. Like, you can't give me a cosign. Look at the people he's cosigning. Like, he not like, yo, DaBaby, that shit hitting. He not, the little skies, that shit.
You know I ain't come to play, let's turn me up. Snapping off the roof, yo, say I'm a favorite nigga. You probably don't want to let your baby mama take a picture. Cause I'm the type of baby that's gonna fuck the babysitter. I just did a show and put up laughing on the hate nigga. Them bitches hit me, they drop fast, I'm on these rapper niggas. As I put in 40 out, he better have an angel with him. Trying to book me for a show, you gotta pay me before I go and feed the family. I ain't got no time to play with niggas. You see? I see these niggas think they tough. You play with me, you know it's up. You think it's sweet, then call my bluff and I'm a spanking nigga. Yeah. Fuck all the niggas and whoever they got hanging with. Bitch, I'm a die of old age.
What's your hot take? What's your joint on that one right there? What you got? What's the slappiest one there?
Let me drive real quick.
You got it, yo. Nah, you got it.
Nah, I just wanted to do the brrr.
Say, bro. That nigga had a whole bunch of slaps on there.
Oh, nah, but did you hear this? Oh, my.
Tupac?
No.
That was the one that had the slaps.
That T-Pain, Tory Lanez.
Yeah, I heard it. Yo, nah, we good. No, we not playing no T-Pain slaps right now. Go back to that DaBaby Tupac. That's the slap right there.
Yeah.
5 slaps, yo. 5 slaps and a possible. Like, 5, one more if you act up, bitch. Like, that's, yeah.
Yeah, I know how it go. Yeah, you put in your work, you deserve. You realize it was all really worth. You were still on your grind. You put in plenty of time and they didn't understand. Them niggas was sleeping. You woke their ass up. But I ain't no alone. You know who I am. And who you is, nigga. I'm like the Tupac of the new shit. 100,000 hoes and they like the way I do shit. I'm the realest nigga rapping. And my bitch like Jay and Vicket. I'm the first person to see it. Shout out Will, no point intended. Hey, who you is, nigga. I'm like the Tupac of the new shit. 100,000 hoes and they like the way I do shit. I'm the realest nigga rapping. And my bitch like Jada Pickett. I'm the fresh prince of my city. Shout out Will, no point intended.
Hey, who you is, nigga. Nigga, I forgot we was podcasting. Speak, yeah, no. Speaking of, five slaps right there, my nigga.
Speaking of Jada Pinkett.
Come on. Come on with it. What you got?
All I know is the nigga news is all on the Kardashians.
Oh, her niece, right?
I mean, no.
That's her niece.
It's Jada. Well, like, it's, Jordan Woods. I think it's that's Will's her niece. Guy's daughter.
That's her niece. Whatever. Type. Whatever. You know, niggas that make somebody
apparently
nephew.
Her dad used to be on
niggas that make somebody cousin
cast, nigga.
Okay.
Before she was even born.
Okay. Come on.
Oh wow. Okay.
But yeah, we're not about to get into much of that, bro. That's a whole bunch of other. But like, they definitely tried to shoot her bell. So Jada Pinkett definitely gave her a lot of bell. But a lot of the chicks is not rolling with the story, bro. That's what I see.
Oh yeah.
Why's that? Poor kid.
Apparently she was at Tristan crew without Chloe. So they already lost her there. She was there kicking it after the club.
You can't do that in black culture. Or you can't do that in
Yeah, that's why they killing her. But she went to the red table and that's what she told everybody. And how she was sitting by the nigga and her leg was on his leg. But that was just it.
Like how? Like they was touching knees or like her
like
leg
she said,
was
she said her leg was on the lower leg. Lower of his shit. But like not on.
But you already violating it.
Yeah. And apparently like, that nigga kissed her when she left. That's her story.
So what now?
He kissed her when she left. She was leaving to go get in her little car or whatever. Apparently my nigga kissed her. That's her story.
In the mouth?
Yeah. I mean.
She didn't say
the cheek. Well, I mean. Apparently this is apparently why
I
this
ain't
is,
kissing none of my wife's homegirls. So I don't know. Like hey, I'm just curious. Like,
I was fucking
out, like,
with the episode before they dropped the Jordan shit. I thought they was gonna wait on the Jordan shit because they just dropped the Wale shit on the Red Pill shit. And I thought that was some pretty good shit.
Yeah,
check it out if you ain't seen it. But they done already dropped the Jordan shit already, nigga. It ain't been no week. I can't remember the last time they had a Red Pill, nigga. This fast, nigga. But they boom emergency episode.
Yeah,
Will recording doing Bad Boys 3.
Right.
He just dropped the whole Facebook show on Facebook too.
Uh-huh.
So they just eating the Facebook bag right now, nigga. The whole Smith family, nigga.
Facebook bag.
I mean, real talk, bro. Like me and my wife got a show on Facebook. And nigga, my son got one of the hottest hip hop albums out.
His son's weirdo, man. I don't like that weirdo rap nigga.
I hear you, but
that
nigga music be going.
Nigga got like a Caesar on one side and like a little mini taper for on the other side. I don't like that weirdo rap nigga. Hey,
I only fuck with it just because that nigga is black.
If I seen Jaden Smith, like if he like ring our doorbell right now, like it's an Uber East nigga, I'd punch him in his fucking chest.
Nah, he just really trying to.
I punch him in his shit and like get my
strength in black culture, bro.
He's what?
He's trying to strengthen black culture, bro.
He's trying to be involved in black culture because he's never been a part of black culture.
Yeah, but like he trying not to put the culture in a box. Like when you see
the culture's not in the box.
Yeah, it is, bro.
All three of us don't even look the same right now.
Exactly, but
so, like,
the people that don't like know that don't know that. But like they know Will Smith.
We all are different niggas.
Yeah, but they see nigga shit. So it's like until
they see
Will
Smith. That's what TV pumps out. That's why we're an independent media platform.
It's important for niggas.
That's why I pay money to get this shit out to people. Like, you know what I'm saying? Because I don't want niggas to be polluted, like thinking that, you know what I'm saying, like the baby is like a nigga that goes around and shoots people. Like that's entertaining to us. We know that. But like you are a white kid in the suburbs, you're right. Like you might just be like, oh yeah, murder, 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 kill, kill, kill. Yeah,
but like
I'm on my
they're not gonna think like go that because it's like, all right, well, Jason,
nigga, you seen them white boys with them durags on? We going a mile a minute right now. Boom. But you see them white boys with them durags on?
I've seen it before.
I've definitely seen some B-Rabbits.
Y'all talk amongst yourself. No.
Please play my
phone. Y'all talk amongst y'all.
He changed his name.
Is it Malibu's Most Wanted?
No.
I'm talking about Spooky Black, bro. I fuck with Spooky Black.
No, I seen some shit, right? Hold on. I seen some
shout
shit.
Shout out to Spooky Black.
I seen some problematic
I'm not an example for people.
Nah, not you, Lil Wayne. Shut up. Hold on. I seen some shit. Let me find that shit.
Josh. Is this your favorite track?
I got 20 on my feet. Y'all need to do that shit. Let me show you. I heard this shit.
That ain't the baby, that's my baby.
Hey, who you?
just a baby, what you heard about me? I put that nigga up, now niggas acting nervous around me. I'm in the rental, trust sticked up like Walker, Texas Ranger. I'm on my grind like fuck a bitch, I get some pussy later. Don't even call my phone, used to be a hater. Could've fucked your bitch, nigga. Yeah, she made my dick soft. I left him to jail, had like 336 miss.
The baby, Walker,
you don't really love me, admit it, bitch. I'm with a bitch from the west side of town. I like my hoes ghetto and pretty. I got that on and I pull it out now. You ain't the only one with it. Boom. I'm trying to go get the cake for my daughter like it's a birthday. Can you
hang
it?
Tell me that like I do my little dance.
I can't really dance, I be jigging. And I'm about to hop on the flight out to Cali. Free Dodge, they got him in print.
Look at this shit. Why you got the do-rag? What's that? You got waves? You getting waves? See, this is what happens in the suburbs. Black culture to another level. Look at that. You're waiting for, where are your waves? Let me see. Check them. Show them. Show your waves. Oh! Wave check. Look at this motherfucker.
Wave check.
This is.
Did you see that shit?
Bam. I see.
White.
And
I mean,
then,
like,
apparently some chicks on the timeline when I was on Twitter scrolling, nigga, they had a wave cap party, my nigga. And my nigga, would you be my friend? He was like, what would happen if y'all had a wave check? He wrote the hook. And I was dying, bro. But nah, I hadn't shared, bro. But I did. I don't be showing my nigga news. I be seeing a lot of, like, them videos, nigga. My nigga news shit is, that's what I...
I'm mad, like, you know, I've been doing nigga news forever, bro. My boy out there, he publicized it. He getting the bag. And apparently there's crackheads outside. Like, he eating you.
Spot on.
Shout out to Hood News Channel 6. Hood News. I see you out there, boy, Granny.
Took me back out there. What was that one movie, bro? Took me right back to that movie, bro.
What movie is that?
Bro, when the dude is... He turned white. You know the movie when he turned white? He be working for the news.
Nah, I know that Eddie Murphy did a skit like that one time.
Nah, that's a real movie.
He did a movie, Trading Places.
Nah.
Oh. Yeah. No, he did a skit one time on Saturday Night Live where he was like, in whiteface, it's mad funny, yo. Yo, what's good? It's your boy, Young Thirsty. Here with the kid, Mr. J. Hunter, Wolfman. Yeah, that's me.
Oh.
And I got my nigga here, Sirius J. Walker. What's happening?
What's good?
Appreciate y'all listening. Shout out to Momo. Not the monster, my grandma. My mama knew.
Type of shit.
I was wrong. 35 years anniversary. Side note. But anyway, appreciate y'all listening. Like, subscribe, give us the 5-star rating. Sorry, we drank too much tonight. But we want to make sure we got the info out there. And, you know, keep your third eye open. You know what I'm saying? The moon is in full Scorpio. We out.